taking me a dime to find my way home. I haven't been far away, but far enough that I gotta say, feel what I gotta feel. The magic is real this Christmas.
Do Merry Christmas, everyone. Merry Christmas. Oh, awesome. You sound lovely tonight. It is truly the most wonderful time of the year. It's a great time for us to be together, and we're so happy that you're here tonight to fellowship with us and celebrate with us. It's going to be a wonderful time. You just heard the Altered Youth Praise Team under the direction of Angela Tackett. Here in just a little bit, you'll see Exaltation under the direction of Gary Turner, and they're going to present us with the Christmas program this evening, and it's going to be a wonderful time. But here in just a second, you're going to see the showstopper of the evening, and that's the Little Tiny Kids, a little ballet under the direction of Stephanie Miller and Miss Katie Coffey. You will see them, and they're going to be awesome. If you would, if you stand for just a second. We are happy. We're excited that you're here tonight. We want you to shake at least three hands. Shake the person on your right, left, behind, and front. Shake their hands as we get started here. Welcome into Stratford Heights. Merry Christmas. It's wonderful to see you all. What a great time. What a great time. All right. Here we go. You want to sit down? Get your camera ready. You have never seen anything more cuter in your entire life.
Show he loves us. The angels told the shepherds, the wise men followed the star. Jesus is born. God has given a son to us. He gave Jesus to show he loves us. The angels told the shepherds, follow the star. Jesus is born. Jesus is born. And they said, when we find the baby Jesus, we will laugh and dance and cheer. So let's go find the baby Jesus. God has given a son to us. He gave Jesus to show he loves us.
Let's go! Amen. I get the honor of following that up. So I know all of our parents are very proud. We're very thankful for Stephanie Miller and her leadership. Can we give them a hand, one more hand, just appreciating them? I know they worked so hard for so many months to perform that, and so we're so thankful for them to perform and all of our leadership. I wanted to ask you a question tonight as we continue in our program. So thankful for this night, for all the hard work that's went into tonight and how incredible it's going to be. I was thinking of this tonight. I was thinking of the wise men that came to the manger where Jesus was. And I thought about this. I thought, you know, I wonder if the wise men really grasped who it was that they were coming to see. I know that they had heard the prophecy. I know that they'd seen the star and they'd followed the star. And this was a promised king. But did they really know the kingdom that he was promised to be enthroned above? Did they really know that he was going to bring healing to the nations? Did they really know that he was going to be salvation? Did they really know what we know tonight? Did they really know that Jesus was more than just a story? He was more than just something or someone that happened. He is the Savior of the world. I don't know about you, but I'm thankful for Christmas, not because of the gifts that I don't get anymore. Now I give gifts. Things have changed. But I'm thankful tonight that Jesus came to save sinners like me. I'm thankful that Jesus came to save sinners like all of us apart from him. I'm thankful he came, and tonight we know that story. Tonight we know that he came to save and change. And we're going to take up the offering tonight. And I just thought about this. This is something over the last couple of years that we've done and I've done, and we've presented this in our offering time. But we always, I just have been thinking about this. This Christmas, I know there's many things pulling at us. There's many things that are telling us to give. But tonight, I just feel led, and I've felt led, and I want you to pray about joining us tonight and just giving a Christmas offering. And it's not to be justified, and there's no plea to make you feel guilty to give. There's really nothing in particular that I'm even asking you to give towards. It's just a gift from our heart to the Lord. It's not anything that says, you know what, I have to do this because I'm a Christian in any way, shape, or form. It's just, you know what, I'm going to be honest. I don't have my gift. The Bible says the wise men, when they saw him, they worshiped him and they reached in their bag. They reached into their treasures and they gave. They reached into their treasures and they gave. There's no reason to reach into their treasures except they were thankful that they had found the one. And tonight, my treasures don't measure up to theirs. But me and my wife, we prayed about this, and we want to give what we can tonight, just as an offering, just to the Lord tonight. I pray you join us in that. If not, then God bless you, and we're so thankful that you're here, and you are going to be blessed tonight in every way. Father, we love you, we praise you, we thank you for this season, what it reminds us of. We're thankful for our families, our little ones, our gifts, and our talents, and God, most importantly, we're thankful for you. God, thank you that you came and saved us. You called us, God, to yourself. We thank you for it in Jesus' name. Amen.
How about that? That's something. That was the Silent Knights. They spell that K-N-I-G-H-T-S, I think. They're a great group, good young people. They work in the music program. We're glad you're here tonight. Tonight is just a worship service. We're going to sing about Jesus coming to save our souls. And how glorious it was on that night. Worship with us as we minister in song.
Baby lay, rich and poor and low. Angel voices fill the air.
not only there, but he's here. I can sense his presence. He has come to save us. It was just a few weeks ago I stood in the manger in Jerusalem or in Bethlehem, and I just couldn't wait to get in there and see it, you know, and to just see what it smelled like and how it felt. Jesus came to us. He was heaven's child. He was sent. God sent his only begotten Son.
Amen. Amen.
That whosoever believes, if you believe tonight, it doesn't matter what your situation is, he came for you. And he lived, and he was crucified, and he rose from the grave. So whatever need you have tonight, that need has already been met because of heaven's child.
Thank you.
Lord, you are holy tonight. We worship you. We magnify you. We praise your holy name.
Yes.
You are holy.
Though he has all power, he was
This is just a congregation. You can sing it with me. Emmanuel.
Why don't you stand with us tonight?
His name.
Once more, let's sing it together.
Emmanuel.
God with us.
Emmanuel. His name is called Emmanuel. Sing it, choir.
He's God with us.
So thankful.
Revealed in us. His name is called Emmanuel.
2 Corinthians chapter 4 and verse 6 says this. It says, "For God, who said, 'Let light shine out of darkness,' made his light shine in our hearts to give us the light of the knowledge of God's glory displayed in the face of Christ. He sent light into the world. It was the shepherds, it was Mary and Joseph, it was the wise men. They all encountered light, had experience with light. And in that experience, their lives were changed. They had no idea in the moments that followed the light that would fill the entire world, speaking to the darkness of our lives. Here we are, thousands of years down the road, and we are singing about the light of Christ. I don't know where you are tonight, and I don't know whether you're facing dark times or lonely times, overwhelming times. We all have days, have times in our lives when we face the hard things in life. But I'm telling you tonight, every song that's been sung tonight, all the messages come together to say one thing. Jesus Christ is still the answer for the whole world, and he is going to remain our King of kings and Lord of lords up until the day that he takes us to our reward. I'm looking forward to that time, and I hope that you are. But you and I tonight have the wonderful opportunity to embrace the light of Christ. We're not asking you to embrace a religion. We're not asking you to embrace a church. We're asking you to embrace a Savior tonight who loves you, who gave himself for you, who came to this earth to give himself so that you could have life and light in your life. How many of you have experienced that tonight? Would you testify with a hand uplifted? Isn't it amazing, the grace, the love, the mercy of God? I want to pray with you right now. Perhaps you are unsettled. Perhaps in this hour you find yourself confused, going through difficult days. I want to pray with you that the light of Christ, the light of the messages of these songs, what a beautiful night. Maybe it's because I've been away for a couple of weeks, but I've cried through every song because I just believe and know that there is no place you can run, no place you can go. The answer is always found in the presence of the light of Christ. That's where our peace is, that's where our joy is, that's where our hope is, and that's where we love. Amen. I want to pray with you. If you're here tonight and you need the light of Christ in your heart and life, then I want you to feel that this is a safe place for you to embrace the light of the Lord. And I want you to know that we're here to be a friend, a brother, a sister in Christ, and we're here to encourage you, and we want to pray alongside of you. So perhaps you're ready to pray, and if you are, then I'm just going to ask everyone if they would bow their heads for just a moment. If you'd say, you know what, I want to make a decision for Jesus. I want the light of Christ, the light of these songs. I want to be able to sing joy to the world, the Lord has come. I want to sing about a silent night, a holy night. I want the experience of joy to the world in my heart. If you want that this evening, would you just slip up your hand right where you are? Say, Pastor, I want to pray that prayer. God bless you. God bless you, young lady. Is there anyone else? I want to pray that prayer tonight. I want Christ. I want the peace of the Lord in my heart and life. The best decision you'll ever make in all of your heart and life. Thank God for these that have lifted their hands. Let's pray with them now. We're going to take you right to the throne of grace. We're going to pray a prayer with you. That the prayer in and of itself is just words. But when it comes from your heart, it starts a whole new revolution of light in your life. And so I'm so thankful tonight that you're ready to do that. Let's pray together. Will you help me, church? Dear Lord Jesus, come into my heart. Come into my life. Be the light of my life. I know that you died on the cross for me, that you rose from the dead, that you came that I might have life. I receive you tonight. Forgive me of my sins. Come into my heart. Help me every day to live for you. And I will serve you till you come for me. You are the Son of God. I believe it in my heart. I declare it now with my confession. Your word says I'm saved. I'm a new creature in Christ Jesus with a brand new heart. And so I thank you. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. Give the Lord praise tonight. What an amazing thing. the love and the power of God. He truly is Emmanuel, God with us.
Oh,
Amen. Won't you stand with me again this evening? Won't you one good time give it up for this band and orchestra and all these singers who have given us a blessing this evening? Have you enjoyed this? We kind of consider the Saturday night crowd. You're the smart folks. You're the ones that come and check us out before we get started. Tomorrow we'll be having services here at Stratford Heights. We'll be talking about Christmas surprises. And then in the evening on Sunday night at 6 o'clock, we'll be repeating this program. You're welcome to come and bring friends along with you. We're glad that you came this evening. Won't you turn to somebody, look at them right in the face, at least two or three people, and say, Merry Christmas. Doesn't that just feel good? None of that happy holiday stuff around here. Merry Christmas! Amen. God bless you. I hope you have a wonderful, wonderful Christmas season. Enjoy it, getting ready for the coming of the Lord as we prepare in our hearts. We got one last song as we're dismissed this evening. I believe it's called the Christmas Canon Rock. Is that right? All right, I'm excited. I can't wait to hear it. God bless you. Shake hands with at least 25 to 30 people before you leave this evening, and be careful on your way home.
Oh,
All right, let's appreciate this group one more time. We'll see you. We got service 8:30, 10:40 in the morning. This program again at 6 o'clock. Let's give it up for these folks one more time. Gary, you ready to rock or what's happening now? We're out of here. God bless you all. Have a wonderful evening.